Hello beautiful people and welcome to a new review on my channel. So today we have the review to the Apple Watch Series 6 and I'm gonna tell you everything that you need to know about this watch. Okay, so the first thing that we have on the new Apple Watch Series 6 is the always on display, and this is a great addition to the Apple Watch because you can just look at the time and see the most important things. You can see how many degrees are outside or how much percentage of the battery you have. And this is just very great that you can see without making the normal gesture, just to see some basic stuff. So on the back side, as you can see, it's a little bit different from the older one because we have the new blood oxygen sensor. And if you are interested about knowing your blood oxygen, this sensor is gonna be just fine. But if you have problems with your blood oxygen, of course you need to buy something more accurate. This is just the watch, and usually if you want to measure your oxygen blood, you need to put something on your finger and that's gonna measure it, and that's gonna be very accurate. This is just a new thing, and it's the first generation, and it's not that accurate on the watch. And I've had some problems. If you just move or stand up, the watch is gonna just show you inaccurate measuring, or either it's gonna show you unsuccessful measurement, and it's not gonna be very accurate. But it's a great addition because, of course, a new feature, it's a new feature. And now I'm gonna show you how it works. You need to wait 15 seconds. You don't have to move a lot. I think you can talk. I don't think that's a problem, but let's see how much oxygen I have in my blood. So it says that I have 97%, and that's usually what I get. Sometimes I get 100, sometimes I get 80 something. But yeah, it's kind of accurate, but don't trust, of course, this watch for these measurements, because if you have real problems, probably it's better to talk to a doctor and to see if everything is wrong. But it's a nice feature, and that's new in the Apple Watch Series 6. A new thing to the iOS 7 in general, it's the sleep app. And this app is gonna allow you to put the Apple Watch to the sleep. And this is very useful if you don't want to be bothered and you just want to sleep. When the Apple Watch is gonna be turned off, it's not gonna wake up, and if you just tap it, it's gonna just show you the date and time, and that's all, with a very low brightness. If you want to turn off this feature, you need to rotate the crown, and this is how you turn off this new feature. Also new to the sleep mode, you get more information about your sleep, how many times you wake up and stuff like that. With the new Apple Watch, we have the faster charging, and the new fast charging, it's very great because you can just charge your watch through the day. This is what I've usually done. When you wake up, you just charge your watch a little bit, and you just go throughout the day. And when you get home and I don't know, you just want to take a shower, and you just charge the watch a little bit. If you are doing this, you are gonna have your Apple Watch always on you, and it's gonna be always ready for use. And also I've tested how faster it charges, and this Apple Watch charges in about an hour and 15 minutes, and that's very fast, and I really like this fast charging. That's a great feature. Also new to the Series 6, we have the Compass app. And as you can see, it's a very cool app. I don't know how accurate it is, and if you want to go hiking and you don't want to get lost, I think this is a good feature. But probably if you are usually going on that kind of trips, you probably already have a compass, and probably it's more accurate. What I also like about the Apple Watches, and this is not a feature just for the Series 6, it's also for the Series 4 or any Apple Watch that you have. These watches are telling you throughout the day to stand or to do some exercises because you didn't close up your rings. And that's a good thing if you work from home, because you usually forget about exercise and stuff like that. And it's a good thing that the watches are your companion, and they are telling you just, hey, get up and do some exercises and close up your rings. I really love this feature because after my first Apple Watch, I started to do some workouts, and it made me happier and healthier. So that's a good thing. So for the final, if you are asking yourself if you should buy this, the Series 6 or the Series 5 or the Series 4, I recommend you get the Series 5 or 6, because they are very similar. And if you're buying a watch, this is not just like a phone that you upgrade it every year or every 2 or 3 years. When you're gonna upgrade it, probably from the series, let's say 6, you're gonna upgrade to the series 10 or 11. So I suggest to buy the latest and greatest or the series 5. And this is why I suggest to either get the Apple Watch Series 6 or Series 5. I don't really recommend anymore the Series 4, because it's a little bit older, and even though it's cheaper, you can also get the Apple Watch SE. And the only difference about that watch and this Series 6 is that this watch has got an always-on display, as you can see, it's shown over here. Also, that watch, it doesn't have a blood oxygen sensor, so that watch is just on Series 4, a little bit updated. This is just my suggestion. If you want to get the watch, I suggest to get the new one. That's all that I want to say in this video, and I hope it was helpful, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And with that said, I hope you are gonna have an amazing day, and be well and be safe.